Welcome to the Angular Stepper component tutorial. The Syncfusion Angular Stepper is a highly customizable component that enables users to navigate through a series of steps or stages in a process within a web application. Steppers display a list of steps, highlighting the current step, and allow users to move between steps. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular application and add the Angular Stepper component. You will also see how to create a checkout page for an e-commerce website with 5 steps, shipping address, payment, order summary, and so on. I will start with the application creation process. I'm going to create an Angular application using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. I will edit my code in Visual Studio Code. To create a project in Angular, I open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the npm install -g at angular/cli command. Next, I will create a new Angular project. I use the ng new project name command and name my project my Angular app. I am creating a project with the option to add a CSS style sheet, so I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started and an Angular project along with its dependencies is being created. Now let me navigate to the project folder. To add the Syncfusion Angular Stepper, install the Syncfusion Angular Navigations package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-navigations --save command. The application is now ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To learn how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion components. Next, I navigate to the app component TS file and import the stepper module and stepper all module from the Syncfusion Angular Navigations package. And register the modules within the imports array of the component section. To apply styles to the stepper component, navigate to the styles CSS file and add CSS references by importing the material theme. Next, I open the app component HTML file and remove the default code. First, I add a division element with a class wrapper. As I said, I will create an e-commerce checkout page with 5 steps, so let me add the stepper component by adding EJ stepper tag. Next, add an eSteps tag which will accept n number of eStep tags. Here, I add 5 steps by adding 5 eStep tags. Then I need to label these steps. I add the label property and set an appropriate text in each step. I save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. You can see that the stepper component is rendered with 5 steps: cart, shipping address, payment method, order preview, and complete. Now I will show you how to customize each step by an icon. I add the icon CSS property and set the predefined class sficonCart. Similarly, I add the icon CSS property in all steps and add the appropriate predefined classes like sficonPayment, sficonPreview, and so on. In the style CSS file, I define a font face with a specific source path, naming its font family as default to access the required font icons at the application level. Subsequently, for those class names assigned to the icon CSS properties, I allocate the necessary content values to access the required font icons. If you want to refer to the content values for the icons, please check the documentation link provided in the description below. Check now, the steps of the stepper component are rendered with labels and icons. In this video, I have shown you how to add the Syncfusion Angular Stepper component to an Angular application. I also showed you how to create a checkout page for an e-commerce website and add labels and icons to each step. To see a working example, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.